Hello students, welcome to the online math class 8. Let us first quickly recap what we learnt in the last class. So we learnt about classification of numbers. Natural numbers are also called counting numbers. By including 0 to the natural numbers, we get whole numbers, that is 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on. The collection of negative and whole numbers is called integers. Numbers which can be expressed as p upon q, where p and q are integers and q is not equal to 0, are called rational numbers. So this is what we discussed in the last class. We also saw this diagram. Natural numbers is the smallest set and can be represented by letter n. Whole numbers is the next set. Then comes the integers. Then come the rational numbers. Rational numbers are the biggest set of numbers. Now in the previous grades, we have learnt about properties of numbers. Let us look at the closure property for different collections of numbers in the today's class. We are discussing the closure property today. So, what is closure property? Closure property states that when mathematical operations are applied to two numbers that belong to the same number set, the result belongs to the same number set. Let us look at the closure property for natural numbers. Now here we are checking if the result belongs to the same number set as the numbers for natural numbers. So we have taken the natural numbers 2 and 3. 2 and 3 both are natural numbers. So let us check with addition first. If we add them, the answer is 5. If we subtract them, the answer is negative 1. When we multiply them, the answer is 6. And when we divide them, the answer is 2 upon 3. Okay. Now, does the result belong to the same number set as the natural numbers? This result, let us check. For addition, the result is 5, which is a natural number. So it belongs to the same set. For subtraction, it is negative 1. It is not a natural number, so it does not belong to the set of natural numbers. Multiplication, the result is 6. It is a natural number. Division, the result is 2 by 3, which is not a natural number. So the result is a natural number only for multiplication and addition. We can say that natural numbers are closed under addition and multiplication. Similarly, let us check if closure property holds true for other number sets. Now, take 2 minutes and you have to check for whole numbers if this closure property holds true for the whole numbers. Okay, you will check all the 4 operations and you will have 2 minutes to check that. Your time starts now. last 10 seconds. Three, two, one, zero. Let us check the answer. So closure property for whole numbers is true for addition and multiplication. It is not true for subtraction and division. Whole numbers are closed under addition and multiplication and not under subtraction and division. Now we will check the closure property for integers. We have checked it for natural numbers and whole numbers. The next set is integers. Now you have 2 minutes to check this for integers. And your time starts now. Last 10 seconds. Time is up. Let us check the answers. So for integers, let us go one by one. For addition, negative 2 plus 0 is negative 2, which is an integer. Integers are closed under addition. In subtraction, negative 3 minus 3 is equal to negative 6, which is also an integer. For multiplication, minus 2 multiplied by 0 is equal to 0, which is also an integer. And for division, negative 2 divided by 3 is minus 2 upon 3, which is not an integer. Okay, so integers are closed under addition, subtraction and multiplication, but not division, because we got a fraction upon division. So this was the closure property for natural numbers, whole numbers and integers. Similarly, let us check if the closure property holds for rational numbers. I'm counting from 1 to 5. Take out your notebooks. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So you have to check for the closure property for rational numbers in a similar way we did for other sets of numbers. Okay? You will have 5 minutes to do this. Your time starts now. You can use the numbers given to check for the closure property. These numbers. Last 10 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. Let us check the answer. So by addition, we got 3 upon 2, which is a rational number. By subtraction, we got negative 11 by 3, which is also a rational number. By multiplication, we got negative 2 by 9, which is also a rational number, and by division, we got negative 2 by 1, which is also a rational number. So, for rational numbers, the closure property holds true for all the operations. Rational numbers are closed under addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. So, what did we learn today? We have learned about closure property on different collection of numbers. Bye. Happy learning.